What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's me, Mikey Pipes. Thank you so much for tuning in. We're going on a service call. We are, means me and Peter, for a homeowner in Lynbrook. We've been coming to this house for years. Really nice couple. I've primarily been dealing with the wife over the years, but they got a drippy water heater. Leak coming from the water here. So let's go see what's going on. Maybe it'll be a great video, maybe it won't, but regardless, I'll still record and hopefully I can entertain and educate at the same time. Blah, a little tongue twister right there. You ready, Peter?
I'm ready.
Smash that thumbs up button, guys. Do it now. You're not Denise, though.
No. Maybe so.
No. Hi, I'm Mike.
Christian. How are you?
Hi, Christian.
Christian, sorry.
Oh, nice car in there.
Yeah, it's a
Triumph?
61 Austin Healey 3000.
Austin Healey? What the hell is that?
Austin Healey? Austin
no, Healy's. I have no idea. Can we see?
Well, of course. So, an Austin
Healey. I have no idea.
They make two versions, a 3000 and a Sprite.
Wow. That's cool. Look at this.
Yeah.
What year is this?
61. This is the only...
I gotta do a video of this.
Car I've ever seen. Like the lines of it and stuff. You gotta see these cars. Look it up on Google. My father and I bought this car when I was 14 years old at the Carlisle Car Show in Hershey, Pennsylvania. And the guy was walking around with a sign over him. You know what I mean?
Why is it a Costco storage location now?
Thank you. I was at Costco yesterday.
With the car?
My wife throws the shit at you.
Oh, come on. You can't disrespect the car like that.
What about my super checks? This is the best thing down here. This thing's probably as much as that thing.
Tell me about the water heater.
It's
dripping. She's a leaker.
And I was told, from somebody that, this pressure relief valve.
Maybe. Temperature and pressure relief valve. We'll go check it out.
We're apologizing for the condition of the basement. Oh, there's another little doggy.
Yeah.
You got two of them. I got two of them, too.
And a cat.
I'm not a fan of pussy cats.
Oh, I love a cat. It's my favorite thing.
Oh, man. Come on.
Yeah, it's terrible.
Yeah, it's time for us to go. I'm not going to take
it's
your
not
money.
Leaking right now, but
I'm not going to take your money. And you have it illegally vented.
Illegal what?
Illegally vented.
Why? This house is redone.
That is a horizontal diverter, and it's not permitted.
How long ago?
20
years.
Yeah. You probably got grandfathered because it was existing. But how old is water heater? It's not that old. Oh, actually, maybe it is.
I probably did this in 07.
This is from 2010.
Okay, 10.
Wow. So I'll tell you what happened to you. Well, I'll tell you what happened. The relief valve has been dripping for an unknown amount of time.
Yeah.
A long time. Right, and it's destroying the jacket.
Yeah.
My first impression is still my best recommendation: replace the heater. But if you like, we'll replace the temperature and pressure relief valve.
Yeah, sure.
Where's the main water valve, though?
Over there.
Do you have a backflow prevention device? Yes, you do. So when you have a backflow prevention device like this right here, this allows water to only travel in one direction, making your potable water system a closed system.
Right.
Which means if I replace the relief valve, it's going to drip again in the future.
How long in the future? Am I going to be
alive? It could be next month, next year. But the solution is to add a domestic thermal expansion tank. That'll make the problem go away.
And then I'm sure it's got to be, like you said, 12 years old.
It is 12 years
eventually
old.
Eventually, it's just got to, old things got to go in this upside
save
down.
Then save your money and replace the water heater. Save your money. We'll put a new water heater in. It's not throwing away the money. If I replace this relief valve, I am not going to guarantee it's not going to drip again.
Drip again when?
Next week, next month, next year, any, no guarantee whatsoever. If I change this relief valve without installing an expansion tank, which is similar to the expansion tank on your boiler, which is this, which is like this. No, I'm giving you professional advice. I'm not here. I've been coming here for many years. I'm just giving you.
You've been here.
Yes, I'm giving you the right advice. Because to change it, and then you call me a year from now or next week, hey, Mike, it's dripping again. And then, oh, how come you didn't tell me? I'll do whatever you want. But if I replace just the relief valve, it's going to drip again. I don't know when. And because you need to install the expansion tank on the water. And I know it hasn't been installed for God knows how long. Because it's never been, you don't have one here.
No.
right? But you have a sprinkler system and you have that backflow prevention on the water main, and it's code. But I'll do whatever you want. I'm not code inspection. I don't work for the village. I work for you. You pay me to do my job.
I think. Well, let's talk numbers.
Is this a 50-gallon water heater? It's 50 gallon water. Yeah. I charge $2,100 for a new A. O. Smith gas fired water heater. That's actually a very good price. Chop it around. For $200 more, I will add an expansion tank, and for another $150 more, I'll make the venting right. Well, let's call it an even number. $2,600 all in.
Okay. How much to replace that pressure leak?
Let me look that up.
I was standing there, and there were five guys, you know, professionals like you behind me. He wouldn't take my. I'm standing there. They fucking just kept going.
There's a rule of thumb.
This guy was an ass.
No, I know, but there's a rule of thumb at supply houses that tradespeople get served first. There is. Sometimes it's posted. Sometimes it's not.
Yeah.
Open that up.
Oh, is that the right?
Yeah.
This guy talked to me like I was fucking 2 years.
You were like the idiot homeowner.
I'll never forget.
What the F is this guy doing? We're gonna F him in the keister.
That was at CNN.
Yep.
I'm standing there.
Fully open? Open. Okay, good. Here. Get something. Yeah, put the bucket right there. No, put the bucket right here. Get something on the right, this right here. Okay, that works too. Good. Let's pop this open. Put it down. Look, it'll drip into the bucket. And it's almost empty. Good. Okay. Prep your long shank relief valve. We'll pop this off, replace the drip leg.
Considered a master plumber? Yes.
Yes.
And then you kind of like do a couple hours or anything, then...
Not a couple hours.
I don't know.
For him to be qualified to take the test, one of two, 7 years of W-2 experience. Yeah.
I say I'm a captain for American Airlines.
Are you really?
Yeah. You fly? I fly the Airbus. I'm a captain.
A380?
I fly the A320, but I also flew the 777 or from 757.
You're a fucking pilot? Really? That's so cool.
Yeah. So my point is, the reason why I ask is because I've been flying with a lot of new hires. and they've already gone through sort of their...
Probation. Yeah, the flight simulators.
I'm just curious what sort of happens at this level.
Peter has been with us for a little over a year.
Okay.
His brother Daniel has worked with me for about a year and a half.
Okay.
His brother is an HVAC technician. I guess technically you call him like a junior technician, but he's in a truck by himself every day and he runs his own service calls.
So is electricians the same 7 years? Is it the same thing?
No, everywhere is different.
Okay.
So in Nassau County, for example, we have different towns, different villages, things like that. But the core, the tri-towns, we have town of Hempstead, town of North Hempstead, town of Oyster Bay, 7 years documented W-2 verifiable experience in order to take the written and then take a practical.
Who's the written? By the state?
The written is by the town. Yeah.
So you're not a master in Pennsylvania?
No, but I am a master plumber in the state of South Carolina. Because I took a separate test there. I'm preparing for my departure.
You're not a master in Pennsylvania?
No. And what's even more interesting... I'll tell you what's more interesting.
Does water flow any differently in Pennsylvania?
Take this off. Yep. All right. You may want to close the valve.
It's literally town dependent?
Let me tell you something. There is 100... Last count, 137 jurisdictions with separate licensing in the metropolitan New York tri-state area. And a majority of them are on Long Island. So, for example, right nearby is Hewlett Bay Park, right? Which is in the five towns. We have Hewlett Harbor. We have Hewlett Neck, right? We have the village of Lawrence, the village of Cedarhurst. You can close that, yes. Right? Those are five. I just counted right there. All within... the jurisdiction of the town of Hempstead, right? But they're separate villages, so there's separate licenses there.
Are the questions?
What are you doing?
Your South Carolina test, were the questions the same as your New York test?
Yes, they were.
They were like, did you marry your...
But what's different about Lefty, Loosey, Righty, Tightey? What are you doing, Godzilla? Come on.
Like, did you marry your brother?
No, it's... There's less questions.
I fly the whole world. I'm everywhere.
There are less questions. It's open book test. But you need to know that you need to know the content.
Open book.
Yes.
I love Charleston. It's my favorite.
I love Charleston too.
My favorite
place. Of Charleston, Myrtle Beach.
If you're
yeah.
A foodie, if you're a foodie, Charleston's got some of the best.
What are you doing?
Chefs.
Why are you playing with that? Take the wrench.
I was just thinking.
Lefty, Loosey, Righty, Tightey. Yeah.
Charleston's got some of the best chefs in the world.
Here. Go like this. Put the wrench on the body of that right there, right? And now apply downward pressure. See, look at that. You did it. You have your valve ready? Where is it? It's on the floor. Right. Now here it is in my hand. Pull that out. Don't stand right in front of it. Because in case you do get some crazy pressure there. Before you do that, actually. See? Go. Come on. Go, 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 go. Well, actually, we could have used a regular shank, but you know it's further away from the body. So when this new drip leg drips, like tomorrow, next week, next month, next year,
it's not good.
Want to bet? I'll bet.
Let's bet. I'll bet you $2,600.
I thought maybe you're gonna bet.
Wait, what's the free? So how about that? Why don't we?
I only fly business or first.
Let's barter. You want to fly to South Carolina for free, or do you want your $344?
I have no problem enjoying my diamond medallion status with Delta.
Oh,
when I because I
first fly of all, first of all,
what are you going to say?
I'm a captain for America. Second yes. of all, you said it wrong. You're from Long Island, right?
Yes.
It's Delta.
Delta.
Anything with an A on the end. Delta.
Delta.
And you're flying to Florida.
Florida. I'm actually flying to Florida tonight.
On Delta?
On Delta.
There you go.
Yep. In row one.
You'll never hear it the same way again because if you're from Delta. Hey, where you go? Florida? Where you
Florida.
From? Delta.
But I do have my American Airlines Admirals Club credit card, which yeah. I pay like $500 a year for.
You got 50,000 miles. You buy as little as a cup of coffee. You know how I know that? Because before I say flight attendants prepare for landing, I turn on the PA to listen so I don't overstep them. Yeah. And as soon as we're done slinging you fucking guys a credit card, I go, flight attendants prepare for landing. So I hear the whole thing. They go, oh, so it was a cup of coffee. You get 50. It's good for 2 round trip tickets anywhere in the domestic. Yeah.
What's the code, Peter?
It's 6.
What's the code? Minimum max. What is it?
Minimum, I believe, is 3 and max is 6.
2 pipe diameters is minimum, 6 inches max.
Oh, yeah. You're getting a trip to your phone.
Well, why?
Well,
okay. All right, Peter. Mm-hmm. New relief valve's in place. Drip leg is in. You can place a small tray underneath. At least it's away from the jacket and it'll stop rotting it out, but. She lived a long life, but when we come back, take a tape measure. Let's measure this so we know what size that is. Can we come back here? We got to change this, I think, 7 or 8 by 3 smoke Y and make that a whatever this is by 4 smoke Y. What do we got there?
This large one?
The large one, yes. What do
so
we have?
Why is it dangerous to be pointing down?
8.
Yeah.
This? A, you're not supposed to decrease the size of the venting on the top of the water heater. So this is a 4-inch, and this is reduced down to 3. And number 2, there's no, it's just not permitted. I couldn't tell you why, but if you look at the manufacturer specifications for what it is, and listen, I've done this before, only as a worst case scenario. Let's say this is a brand new water heater. You had some hacks to put this in. You're like, Mike, I don't want to replace it. I spent $4,000, whatever $1,000 for it is. Can we just do something about this temporarily? Or buy me some time, I'll buy a diverter, horizontal 4-inch, as long as that's the right size to make it work. But because sometimes you need a low boy. This is a standard height. Sometimes the chimney, breaching the chimney is too low. Correct. But that is where the air gets sucked into for draft to occur. Draft is air being brought out through the bottom, which I'm sure is not really occurring at all. Going through the water heater, the flue passes away the water heater. There is bringing in air, similar to the box in the back of the boiler, and it goes up the chimney that way. What's up? Hi. How are you? You're a good dog. Yeah. I don't know, but they're the same. And they're soft. And your tails are wagging. Yeah. Tails are wagging. Hi. Tail. Tails are wagging. You're a good dog. Peter, see? Oh, Peter's not scared of little dogs. Just dogs that bite.
If they're not aggressive off the bat, I'm cool.
Ladies, he likes dogs.